Manatees tend to get entangled in pretty much anything that's left in the water. They're extremely curious, but in many cases they can't see some of the things they encounter, like monofilament fishing line. Another thing they get entangled in is crab traps. That's a more active type of entanglement. The animals actually are curious. They rub their flippers against it. They get a little spooked. They flip over and they end up taking the trap with them. Gradually tightens and it becomes an entanglement. Unlike most fully aquatic marine mammals, manatees use their flippers for quite a number of things. They nurse their calves from the base of the flipper. They use their flippers to pull themselves through shallow water. They use their flippers in mating. They use their flippers to rub their face. These are usable flippers. They're not just used for steerage. So loss of the use of a flipper can affect quite a number of factors in their natural life. Manatees are unique in that their mammary glands are in the axilla, or the attachment point of their flipper. That allows the calf to swim up behind them from underneath and hydrodynamically attach themselves while still swimming and nurse at the same time. It's very advantageous for them, so the manatees don't have to stop when they need to nurse. When the monofilament is in the axilla area, the equivalent of our armpit, it can actually damage the mammary glands. Now they have two, but generally they switch off which mammary gland they're feeding the calf from. So to be down to one can possibly negatively affect the growth of the calf.
Here at Blue Spring, we have our problems with manatee entanglements, just like they do throughout the state. When I first came, we only had two manatees with entanglement problems. But as time has gone by, and there's more and more fishermen and more manatees coming into Blue Spring, we see more and more line entanglements. Even our adoptees get entangled. Back when Margarito was only a year old, he got a rather light entanglement. It started out with some line, hyacinth, and lead sinker, and it was easily removed. But 10 years later, Margarito got another entanglement, and this one was quite a different case. The entanglement was far more serious, deep into the flipper. The flipper was swollen and terrible looking. Margarito had to go to SeaWorld. After 3 days, when they were sure they had gotten all of the line out of the deep cut in his flipper, they brought him back and released him.
Monofilament line, unfortunately, is a byproduct of the fishing industry, recreational fishing, commercial fishing. It tends to get caught and snagged on things, and the immediate response is usually to cut the line, and unfortunately many people do not recover it when they cut it. So it's found in areas that manatees visit, like seagrass beds, around jetties, places where manatees encounter it but they can't see it. It's clear in the water. The first thing we ask for is somebody who sees an entanglement to try and get a picture, not of the entanglement necessarily itself, but actually of the animal's back, so we can see if it's an animal that we're familiar with and if we're just dealing with scar tissue that's left over from a previous injury, or if it's an animal we know that we've been trying to catch, or if it's an animal that came in from another area. That allows us to verify that we've found the right animal and to put together a rescue plan. If the animal is in a situation where we can just swim up to it and clip the line, we do that. We ask that people don't do that themselves, because if it's eating into the flesh or cutting down deep into the flesh, by doing that you could actually release, say, a ligated artery or vein, which is being held in place by that line. We ask that you call the Fish and Wildlife Commission. We will send out experienced people to assess the animal and put together a rescue if necessary. Some can be handled in the field, and some have to be taken to a facility for the proper medical treatment.
About midway between Margarito's two entanglements, his sister Lilith got a line entanglement on her flipper. We got her captured, we got her to SeaWorld, where they had to do quite a bit of treatment. Unfortunately, Margarito, after 2 years, or 2 years after his treatment, lost his flipper, but Lilith, his sister, was able to keep hers and is still doing well today and having many calves.
Whether or not an animal gets to keep its flipper depends on the entanglement, the severity, and how long and how tight the entanglement is. Monofilament is something they cannot remove on their own, obviously. They have no thumbs. Monofilament tends to cut through flesh very quickly. It's not reported as easily as a crab trap entanglement, but crab trap entanglements can be extremely severe and cost the animal their flipper because they're carrying quite a bit of weight if the trap is still attached. Much of the monofilament that's discarded in seagrass bed areas are in the same spot where manatees feed, and they can't see it, so when they're mowing the lawn or mowing the seagrass, they ingest the monofilament as well. Much of the monofilament will pass without harming the animal, but monofilament, particularly that has hooks or any type of leaders or any type of wire on it, pose a serious threat because it can hook into the animal's digestive tract and cause its intestines to telescope. This is almost always fatal.
as well as line entanglements on the outside, on scars in the tail, on flippers, on the body. You could also have what you might call an internal entanglement, where the animal consumes line that's in the vegetation it's eating and causes blockages in the intestine. And here this last year, we lost two animals. We lost both Ada, a female that's had a couple of calves for us, and Conan, a very young male. And in this case, they went out, they seemed perfectly healthy, and then we were notified they'd been picked up by the recovery teams, and the cause of death turned out to be internal blockages from line in their intestines. Jessica is another one of our Blue Spring manatees who suffered from an entanglement. Unfortunately, her injuries were so severe she lost her left flipper.
To give you some perspective, this is the flipper assembly without the hand portion of a manatee flipper. They actually look very similar to ours. This is the humerus, or the upper arm, and these are the two bones of the lower arm, the radius and the ulna. They should slide past each other easily. That's why manatees can bend their flippers. They have this joint very similar to ours. This is a normal, relatively normal looking one. She had repeat entangled, and this is monofilament that is going through her humerus and completely going into the bone. So you can see the bone has remodeled and reformulated. Any further down, it probably would have fused the joint, meaning she couldn't move the flipper at the elbow. Many of the animals we recover have that type of injury. You can see that it actually damaged the bone on the radius and the ulna. Her other flipper, her left flipper, so that was her right flipper, likewise had monofilament, not affecting the joint as much, but definitely causing some reformulation of bone. And you can see that it has mutilated the bone, and it would work its way eventually all the way through to the other side. So this animal probably spun around when it realized it was entangled, because it could feel it, and eventually it wrapped completely around the flipper. This is wrapped probably 7 or 8 times around the flipper. We can get those animals while they're alive and get the medical treatment. In many cases, we can save the flipper.
Report injured manatees to the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission. Call 1-888-404-3922. Store loose pieces of fishing line. Even tag ends cut from leaders can be stored easily for proper disposal. Whenever possible, retrieve and properly dispose of any fishing line you encounter. Recycle fishing line at local tackle shops or bins posted at most boat ramps or piers. Participate in local beach and river cleanup events. At a recent cleanup in New Smyrna Beach, 97 pounds of monofilament line and other debris were picked up.